Go.
Hi there. Thank you for joining us today. And thank you for coming to church today. This is Beautiful Place Parish. And I bring you God's word and God's mind for this week. And I pray that as you listen, be blessed in the name of Jesus. Mind you, my vision is to present God's word to you in a balanced Bible-based perspective so that you can be aptly relevant and heavenly minded. I'm persuaded in my mind, happy and blessed you will be if you will do that. Please like, comment, and share this message. Don't let it die. In Jesus' name, amen.
Of abundance, new doors have been opened. The land, it is green. A new grace has been released. There's an outpouring of abundance,
new doors have been opened.
The land, it is green. A new grace has been released. The glory of the land is greater than the former. The blessing is here. Is all here.
All here.
The glory of the latter is greater than the former. The blessing is here.
Is all here.
Is all here. There's an overflow. Abundance of favor. Abundance of favor.
moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost. I am faithful. I am walking in abundance.
In abundance.
Moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost.
This one prayer point and point direct the prayer point to three people. Three things are revealed in that song. Say in the name of Jesus. Oh, point to three people or hold your hands. Say in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare you will walk in abundance. You will move with the speed of the Holy Ghost. God will begin to favor you. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare over your life, you will walk in abundance. Yes, yes, lack, poverty, impoverishment will be over in your life. I decree and declare, you will walk in abundance. You will move with the speed of the Holy Ghost. You will be favored this week, this month, for the rest of your life. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare you will walk in abundance. You will move with the speed of the Holy Ghost.
You will be favored. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say after me, say, I decree and declare. As I'll be taught the word of God today. Come on, say, my mind will be fruitful. My spirit will be alive. Will be alert. Come on, say, my understanding will produce resolve. My life will not be remain the same. Come on, say, I will be blessed. I'll be transformed. I'll be changed. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father. Heavenly Father, we are grateful for the privilege to come into your house this morning. And we are grateful for the privilege to lead us. Lord, I don't know why I'm excited. I pray that you will extend the same feel of your glory and presence in this place to everyone that will hear me. Not just through this medium alone, through internet, through online, through the YouTube. Lord, I pray that this message will not die. Lord, I pray that you will use it to pull somebody out of poverty, impoverishment, limitations, delay, that yokes around financial impossibility will be broken in the name of Jesus. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Praise the name of the Lord. Sometimes as a preacher, when you want to preach, have your seat in the presence of the Lord. I thought I didn't like money. When you want to preach, the first thing that came to your mind is always very exciting. I thought I don't like money this morning, so I was having a conversation with Emanuela. And I don't know what she said. And she said, I said, between me and your mom, who likes money? I said, your mom likes money more than me. Don't you see that your mommy loves to spend a lot of money? And she paused. We were in the bathroom together. I was shaving. And she paused. And said, please, the voice, if you have children and they are to be this side, just move to this side. Because it will really, really disturb those people listening to the YouTube. So she paused for a second and then she said, but you like money more than mommy. That's why you have a lot of business. I said, how come this girl think this way? Because he sees me, I just want to do so many things. Really, I'm not a sit-down person. My brain always works. And I have a lot of interest as well. So I jokingly said to her, I said, look, you are the reason why I have a lot of business. Say, how much did you spend this weekend? If I tell you that I don't have money, what will you do? Praise the name of the Lord. It's not... I've always been thinking that I don't like money. Please tell the person next to you, there's nothing wrong in liking money. In fact, do you know, money is not immoral. Money is amoral. Money is not immoral, money is amoral. Money takes on the personality of the person that owns that money. So if you think money is immoral, take it away from you. The Bible did not say the love of money. The Bible did not say money is the root of all evil, as many people quote, but it says the love of it. In other words, when you have a choice to make about God, about integrity and about heaven, and you make the other way around choice, then something is wrong. Praise the name of the Lord. I pray that you'll be blessed by this teaching in Jesus' name. So this morning, I will go to the board again. And I have a question for somebody. I don't know, maybe the question should be worth $1,000. I want to talk about three things actually. I want to talk about vision. And I want to talk about money. So watch my diagram. When I was growing up, maybe only a few of us here that are maybe born in the early 60s and 70s, with the exception of Stephen, because he was born in 2002. I'm just joking. Now, with the exception of Stephen, in the sense that the illustration I want to give relates to Nigeria. When you were growing up, and quite a lot of you may not even know, but do you know that it is a confirmed statistic that the African's richest man is a Nigerian? Some of you know his name, or you don't know his name. Some people even wish to be his daughter. Praise the name of the Lord. It is also confirmed that the African richest woman, do you know that? Is also a Nigerian. And her name is Alakija. She's even an evangelist. She conducts crusade. But that woman has money. But do you know when we were growing up, especially for me that grew up in the West, there were some names that we used to hear in those days. I'm still wondering, and maybe you are wondering like I'm wondering, what happened in their life? How many of you heard about Tewo Bade? I know that you. I know all of you don't know about him. How many of you heard about Nwanyawu?
My lecturer.
Nwanyawu, he lectured you.
My course advisor.
He was your course advisor.
That is his name.
No, not that one. But the popular Nwanyawu National.
You know him.
Praise the name of the Lord. When we were growing up in the 70s, in the 80s, in Nigeria, I don't know about New Zealand more because I didn't grow up here. But those are the people that really had money. You have not had enough. There's another guy called Oluwalogbon in the West. That one shocked me because when I was managing a company in Ibadan, suddenly the driver of that company called me and said, "Can you see that man walking on the streets of Ibadan?" I said, "Yes, I can see him. I think he was having a sleeper phone." He said, "Do you know, the man is quite older than me." So that was the driver of the company. He said, "Do you know that is Oluwalogbon that is walking?" I said, "God." I said, "What happened to him? What happened to his money? What happened to his motor business that was all over Nigeria? Was it money that got finished in their hands or something else?" Now you know how. Now, I think, where was Dangote when a man called Abiola was alive in Nigeria? This man has money to the extent that his name that was NKO, Moshu, Kashimawo, Abiola, every musician sang about him. A popular musician changed that name and said M for money, K for Kudi, O for Owo. Go to Nigeria in the 80s, Concord newspaper, Abiola Press, Abiola Bookstore, Concord Airline, Concord this, Concord that. Suddenly, Abiola died. Maybe you don't know. It will interest you to also know that naturally, it has been established scientifically that people with first class brains are not good businessmen. Google it. Most of them are all usually theoretical people who love to be employed. But Abiola was different. He has a first class in accounting and he was a chartered accountant and was a very shrewd businessman. So he died with so many wives and so many children. I'm from Abeokuta, and the first thing I noticed was Abiola Bookstore was gone. Can you see Fly Concord Airlines was gone? And they started fighting over his money. Where was Otedola? Those of you that know those people that are now rich, they weren't there in those days. Now this is my question. What finished in the family? Was it vision or money? My second question is this. What brings money? Is it money that produces vision or vision that produces money? Or is it money that replicates money? When I was in secondary school, I never knew I'm going to study accounting. I was in the science class. And my economist teacher taught me, he said, poverty, replicate poverty. He said it's an economic principle. That if you come from a rich family, you are likely to be rich. So the question is this. What finish in those people's life? Who wants to answer me? Do you think it is money that produces money? Money can come to your life through several means. Gift, lottery. Also, there were so many famous entertainers and sportsmen that have gone broke. And they also sold their houses. What happened to them? Also, there are so many money inheritors. Those who inherited big money that are now broke. What got finished in their hand? So the question is this. Is it money that reproduces or replicates money? Or is it vision that produces money or money produces vision? Who wants to answer?
Vision, of course, obviously. That produces money. If you have vision, you get money. I mean, vision now guides you to make money. It's
but
very
simple
analysis.
But you need money to execute the vision.
I mean, you have a vision.
Okay, let's get it one after the other. I'll give you the mic. I'm serious.
Yeah, what I'm saying is, because I just spoke of vision yesterday. Yeah. Vision gives you direction, it gives you a purpose. It leads you. It's like a steering wheel on what you're doing. So it's through your vision that you'll be able to get money. Because without vision and you get money, you will not know what to do with the money. The problem with most of the people you just mentioned is because the visionary person was removed.
Yeah.
Because the person was removed, those that the money was left for them, they don't know how the vision, they don't know what to do with the vision. That is why the money got finished.
Mm.
Money that you just keep and keep on taking without replacing it, of course, eventually to get finished.
Yeah.
So it is vision that brings in money, not money that brings in vision.
Clap your hands and celebrate that. Do you have contribution? You said, but you didn't bring money to execute it. Yeah, okay. I thought you want to talk first. Go, come on. Come. Then I'll give it to others.
I think both of them come in place. Because when you have a vision, you actually need... I mean, somebody that is just like somebody that has a vision and doesn't have any money. So, your vision can die if you don't have that money. So you still need a little bit of money to start that vision. So it's just like saying, which one comes first, egg or chicken?
Mm.
Which one comes first? So both of them has their own contribution. But vision is the main, if you have a vision and you have a little money, that can turn everything.
So what you're saying is that if you don't have money at all,
if you don't have
vision,
money,
is useless.
Yes, take for instance, let's look at Africa. There are many of people there that have vision, that have a lot of great ideas. Why is their vision not coming to pass? There's a number of people that are on the grave, that are already dead, that passed away, due to what? Money. So you need a little bit of money to carry out your vision. To just start, it's just like a car. We look at the car. Look at the whole big car. Everything, when you look at that car there, you will think, okay, the battery is a huge thing in the car, but it's not. There's a little tiny thing which we call fuse. Without that fuse, that car won't start. So there's a number of everything come, everything work for you.
QED.
Yeah.
I will concur with the lady. Although, while not doing away with what Tope said, just like you said the other time, Pastor, that there is possibility of you getting rich if you come from a rich family. But it doesn't mean totally you have to come from a rich family before you can. But why we say vision brings money is that Abiola never came from, Abiola you mentioned, never came from a rich family. If I came from the poor of the poorest family, but his vision made him what he is. If the vision he has to We never know. We never knew what Mohammed his vision now, but we just know.
I have a lot of information. He's my townsman.
I know.
The first time he had egg.
It was in his in-law's house. In-law's house.
He has a big foot while he was in school.
Yeah.
So he couldn't
afford shoes because he cannot make special food for him. So I think it is his vision that led him to having that money. Though that money, we continue to produce money. And when the visioner, the visionary, or what
no, two things. The vision is different from the visioner.
Of course.
So when the vision and the vision now die.
Now die.
Money will die.
It is definitely go.
Yeah, right.
Oh. Any other person?
Cough. Well, there's some couple of biblical verses, but one says, delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. And I think vision, well, it's that verse which says, God steers the thoughts and the mind of kings and rulers. Though they may, in a sense, think they're doing what they're doing on their own accord. You may have vision, but unless God blesses the vision you have, and he can see where it will lead, and it's to his purpose, and you commit it to him, even vision, in the secular world, I think I quoted it before, there's this verse on our goes, how many times have you heard someone say, if I had the money, I'd do things my way? But little do they know, it's so hard to find a rich man in ten with a satisfied mind. Once I was waiting in fortune and fame, everything I needed to get a start in life's game. But suddenly it happened, I lost every dime, but I'm richer by far with a satisfied mind. See, everybody has a vacuum inside them, don't they?
Yep.
And it can only be filled with one thing, God, and from that other things flow out.
Pastor, just 1 minute.
Okay, I'll give you. Go on.
Let me just in line with what Tokwe just said, you don't necessarily need money to make your vision come to pass. Mm. I'll give you an example. You know Tesla and the SpaceX that we're hearing? They're doing exploitation in Mars, although I don't support them going to Mars. Elon Musk.
Oh, that's another topic for another day.
Yeah. Elon Musk, who happens to be the CEO of both companies, he has so many companies. He had the right background, he studied, and with the right, it was his brain that he used to start his first business. He never had enough money. It was from the first business that he sold, which he partnered with PayPal. He had other businesses, but one of them was PayPal. He partnered with the people that started PayPal. And PayPal today, he sold it from the proceeds he got from PayPal. He reinvested it. He has a vision that he's going to make things that his own vision was to make, produce things that will be renewable energy and affordable. And that is what his vision is. So you don't necessarily, you could start anything with even $100. Once you have a vision, believe me, with $100 you can go far. So you don't necessarily need money for your vision to come to pass. I mean, for you to make your vision work. Thank you.
I won't preach. Clap your hands, everybody. Now let me preach. If I give you opportunity, I will preach. And it's not literally a debating week. Praise the name of the Lord. Everybody say Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Help us.
Help us.
He will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But let me be frank with you. What the Lord has taught me over time is perfectly in line with what Ladi said. It's not to say that what Rotokwe said is not right. The people that have vision and had no money, it's not because they will not have money. Something is separating them from that big money, and I'm going to show you, which is the third thing that I'm going to tell you today. But what the Holy Spirit has taught me over time
with practical testimonies is that money never produces vision. In fact, there are a lot of people with money. Without vision, the money will finish. But if you have vision today and you don't have a dime, money will come. It may take time. If you understand and do the right thing, it may take time, but money will come. You may not agree with me because there is always an internalization process to every principle. But take it with, from me, this is what the Holy Spirit taught me. Money never produces vision. It is vision that produces money. Number two, don't forget also that the Lord told us that the capacity of our imagination has a lot to play in producing testimony this year, the excellent breakthrough. So if you cannot imagine it with the heights of faith, you may not be able to see it. What is the third missing link? I'm going to share it with you. Look at Ezekiel chapter 47, verse 1 to 5. Ezekiel chapter 47, verse 1 to 5. Who are the four beneficiaries of money? And what category of these four types of beneficiaries do you belong to? Look at Ezekiel 47, verse 1 to 5. Let's quickly, so that we can... it's like my spirit has so much to pour out. So let's look at it together. It's like our... this thing is freezing or what? Let's go to Ezekiel 47 with your Living Bible. It says, afterward, he brought me again unto the door of the house. And behold, there waters issued out from under the threshold of the house eastward. For the forefront of the house stood towards the east. And the waters came down from under the right side of the house at the south side of the altar. Bring Ebuse to the altar. Ebuse. Bring Ebuse to the side. And when the man that had the line in his hand went forth eastward and measured 1,000 cubits, he brought me through the waters. The waters were to the ankles. Everybody say ankles. Again, he measured 1,000 and brought me through the waters. The waters were to the knees. Everybody say knees. Again, he measured 1,000 and brought me through. The waters were to the loins. Everybody say loins. Afterward, he measured 1,000 and it was a river that I could not pass over. For the waters were risen, waters to swim in. A river that could not be passed over. Everybody say four type of beneficiaries of money. It's revealed in that scripture. Where was it? Where are the first type of beneficiary? Those whose level of benefit they enjoy from money is to the ankles. You know ankles? Yeah. Those who benefit of money, I'm going to put it in literal understanding for you, of money is to the knees. Those whose benefit of money is to the loins around this place. And in accounting, we call it break-even point. Those whose benefit of money is not to their shoulders, I thought, it's not to their head. It's way, way above their head. It becomes an overflow. It is called an abundance. And they have to just swim in it. What benefit of money do you have? Are you at the ankle level? Now listen to what God told me. If your benefit of money is to the ankle level, it means that you have nothing. It means you are poor. If your benefit of the money that you enjoy presently is to the knees, it means that you have just enough or just a little enough. The categories to which a lot of us belong to. It means you are rich. See, my statistic is so narrow. That's why I could classify poor people in between the ankle and the knees. But I choose not to. If your benefit of money, if you have less than you needed, less, if you have nothing and less than enough, you are poor. If you live from paycheck to paycheck, you are poor. If you don't have any reserve in your account, either in naira or dollar, you are poor. So that you will know how to pray. So that you will know how to think. so that you will know how to. If they send you today, let's be realistic. Do you have any assets? You will not have cash in your bank account. That's another dimension. But can you raise 10 million naira today? What do you have to convert to 10 million naira? Can you raise $1 million? Can you raise $500,000? What do you have that you can convert? Do you think it is the milk in your fridge that you will convert? I'm sorry to disappoint a lot of us. So the third category of beneficiaries of money is called the wealthy. Those who have more than enough. Some of us may be there. Some of us may not be there. The fourth category are the affluent. Those who have multiple, multiply, and multitudes in abundance. They have more than what they needed. Praise the name of the Lord. Now the Lord told me, in life, it is either you are pursuing one of your vanities or your vision. But don't forget it, only vision produces money. And God said, vanities will produce riches with wings, and they will eventually fly away. Or if you are living for vanity, your vanity is like a flame that are like flames. They will also pass away. Look at Proverbs chapter 23, verse 5. Proverbs, are you being blessed?
Yes.
Proverbs 23, verse 5. The missing link. I'm going to show you the missing link. The missing link. Look at it. Read it with me, church. Want to go? Will thou set thy eyes upon that which is not? For riches, whether you like it or not, money has a flow. And the timing of the flow is always periodic in the life of any man. What changed Abiola that we talk about is the ITT contract. But what changed Abiola that we talk about, you need to read about rich people so that you can be rich, was not the ITT contract, I'm sorry to say, but what he did with the inflow that came when that ITT contract came, because it only came once in his life. That's why, you know, some of our teenagers, we are fighting with them. Because when we were growing up, they taught us, they said, the first money that comes into the hands of a teenager, he uses it to buy bread and big cake. And when you teach our teenagers these days, I said, the money that is coming to your hand now, you are using it to buy bread and big cake. Say, no, no. Because money will, at a particular time, you may struck some money that you never expected. But what you do with that money will determine the rest of your life. Whether you are going to be poor or rich. Everybody say, Holy Spirit. Say it again. Say, Holy Spirit. Help me. Help us. So the question is this. Are you poor with nothing? Are you rich with just enough or a little above? Are you wealthy with more than enough? Are you the affluent with multiple, multiplied and multitudes in abundance of provision? Vision. What is vision? God told me, and it's in my book, if you choose to read it and buy. Vision is a mental or supernatural printed picture of your future. It is a mental, so it doesn't have to be supernatural, but it could be supernatural. Printed picture of your future. Vision can happen either in the day or in the night. But I want to let you know, it is cheap to have a vision. It is cheap to dream. The more you dream, the better your destiny becomes. Praise the name of the Lord. There's one advertisement when I was growing up. I don't know how many people saw that advert. It's an advert of a mechanic apprentice. It go better, life go better. That was the song that was attached to the advert. You remember the advert? And the stupid boy, his dad was walking somewhere in the mechanic workshop. And the boy, you know, somebody brought a brand new car to be fixed in their workshop. It's an advert in Nigeria. And the stupid boy took his 3310 phone and went inside
the owner's seat and closed his eyes and pretended he became a very rich guy. And then he was dreaming as if he was in flowing clothing, agbada, you know. And then he was dreaming that he became a rich man. And all of a sudden, his oga called him and said, "Come on!" And then he came back to reality and he started mechanic clothes. The question is this: that was a very good advice. It's a matter of time if he keeps that dream on his mind. The image that you printed on your mind and you keep on your mind, you eventually become. What you have today is a product of the images that you have kept of your mind, of yourself. The images of your future are the things that are playing up in your mind now. Keep them. Don't let the devil steal them away from you. Come on, say vision. So vision is a mental or supernatural printed picture of your future. Vision can happen either in the day. Look at Habakkuk chapter 2. That's why don't waste your vision. When you have a vision, either through dreams or through thinking or through imagination or through attending a seminar like some women attended yesterday and their spirits were fired up, write it down. Hallelujah. Look at it. Let's read it together. I want to be fast. He says, "I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower, and will watch to see what he will say unto me, and what shall I answer when I am reproved." Verse 2. Let's be fast. He says, "And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision." Do you have visions you have written? Do you have a vision journal? Vision board. He said, write the vision. The vision you don't write, you will forget. Some of you have perfect images that can turn your life around, that can give you the breakthrough you have been praying for. You never wrote it down, you've forgotten it. I make it plain upon tables. One day you will stumble on it and your mind will begin. See, that's why. You see, somebody said, you can't travel within and stand still without. When your mind is active, it's in the Holy Ghost. That it may run that read it, even if you don't fulfill that vision. I have things that I've written down that I believe that these girls, one day they will stumble on some of them and they'll say, "My dad wrote this down and he wanted to achieve it. He could not achieve it. I will achieve it." Do you have such journals in your house? Praise the name of the Lord. It doesn't matter whether the vision comes to pass in your day or comes to pass in your son's day or your daughter's days. The most important thing is the vision comes to pass. David had a vision to build a house. He never built it. But who brought it to pass? His son. Because he knew what his dad, he knew the design in his father's mind. And so he saw it and he replicated it. Clap your hands and celebrate Jesus. Look at verse 3, quickly. "For the vision is yet for an opportune time. But at the end he shall speak and not lie. Don't he tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come to pass. It will not tarry." Clap your hands and celebrate Jesus. Come on, say after me. Say, "God will not fail." Say to yourself, say, "God will not fail. His word will surely come to pass in my life. He will never lie. God will not fail. His word will surely come to pass in my life. He will never Proverbs chapter 29 verse 18. I pray that we will have enough time. Proverbs 29 verse 18. This one is so powerful. This one is so good. Hallelujah. Let's read together. One, two, go. "Where there is no vision, either in the life of an individual, of a family." A family that lacks direction without vision will not achieve anything in 5 years' time. A church that lacks direction or vision will not achieve anything in 5 years' time. So is a nation. Where there is no vision, it's such a powerful word. Without vision, you will perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, I'm going to use something. So what is the missing thing? What is the missing thing? What is the missing thing? Everybody say pro. Pro. Everybody say pro. What is the meaning of the English word pro? Don't forget we have protection. I used to tell people, English is very easy to learn. Protection.
Protection. Protestants. There was a time some people were merchandising people's faith. They were called Catholics. And they were telling people, if you come to church, you pay tithe, you go to heaven. And they have tithe cards. That was Catholicism for you. And they were telling people to buy seats in the church. They were telling people to clean. Romane knows what I'm talking about. He was a Catholic. And they were telling people that the more seats they clean, am I lying? So praise the name of the Lord. So, and a man began to study the scripture. He studied Ephesians, and he stumbled Ephesians chapter 2 verse 8. His name is Luther. He's not an American, he's a German. And he says, he saw that for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourself. He said, it is the gift of God. It is the gift of God, lest any man should boast. Not of works. And the Holy Spirit blew that revelation on his mind. Not of work, it's by grace. And he stood up and started a movement that produces Pentecostalism, Pentecostalism, produces orthodoxy, produces so many churches. They call themselves Protestants. So what does pro mean? Pro means in support of. Everybody say in support of. What is pro? In support. Everybody say in support of. So what is my conclusion? What is the missing link? There is something called provision. And it's very common. So what the Lord taught me is this. There is a support for every vision that you have. It is not called money. Brother Pepe. If you see somebody that has a vision and does not have money, he's looking for money. What he should be looking for is provision. The support that heaven has made available for that vision that he has. Clap your hands and celebrate God. Now, as I round up, finally, I'm going to give you 12 things. The Lord now taught me, and I have never seen it this way before. God told me this week, he said, we are all looking for money. We are all looking for money. He said, but hidden and disguised in forms of provision in the Bible is support for every vision that you have. But they are not called money in the Bible. They are disguised. They are hidden. They are called different things. So if you are looking for the support for your vision, look for those 12 things. Number one, First Samuel chapter 25. What is the first thing that God has provided as a support for the vision that you are looking for? If you don't have this, you cannot get it. I call them the triple P. The triple P's. And Samuel died and all Israel were gathered together. Let's go to verse 2 quickly. Let's go to verse 2. And there was a man in Maon whose possessions were in Carmel. And the man was very great. And he had 3,000 sheep and 1,000 goats. And he was sharing his sheep in Carmel. No doubt this guy is rich, is wealthy. Look at verse 3. But this is the pro. The reason why he was rich. And he almost lost it. Now the name of the man was Nabal, and the name of his wife Abigail, and she was a woman of good understanding and of a beautiful countenance. Look at verse 4. This is the reason why he was rich. Verse 4, quickly. And David had in the wilderness that Nabal did share his sheep. Verse 5. And David sent out young men, and David said unto the young man, get you to Carmel, verse 6, and go to Nabal. And greet him, and thus shall he say to him that liveth in prosperity. This is the reason for his prophecy. Peace be to you, peace be to your house, and peace to all that you have. Look at somebody and say, peace to you.
Peace to
your house. And peace to all that you have. Because if you don't have peace in those triple dimensions, you can't have prosperity. Do you know why David could not build a house? He was a man of war. He was a warrior. He was a bloody man. Even if he starts building the house, war will come. He will not be able to finish it. God said, no, you can't build. Look at the Bible. Go and read the Bible very well. The peace that Solomon had was supernatural. He fought no war. The peace that Solomon had was supernatural. He fought no war. Nobody can prosper in the midst of war. So if you are looking for provision for your vision, pray for peace. Peace at home. Say it again. Say to somebody, so this is the disguise of provision for your vision. Say it again. Say to your wife, say peace to you. Peace to all your house. And peace to all that you have. Job knows what it means. What it means not to have peace around what you have. Hallelujah. What is the second disguise of provision? It is called seed. It's not called money. It is called seed. Look at Genesis chapter 8 verse 22. It says, for as long as heaven and earth stands, it says seed time and harvest time shall not cease. So the second provision, the second support God has given to you for your vision is called seed. Seed of your time. Seed of your talent. Seed of your skill. Clap your hands and celebrate Jesus. Everybody say seed of your time.
Seed of your
talent.
Seed of your talent.
And seed of your skill.
And seed of
your skill. You may not have money, but you have time. Hallelujah. And we always say time. The second disguise of provision is called harvest. Harvest. Which is the result from the seed of your time. Hallelujah. Number four. The second provision for your support for your vision is called giving. Stop looking for money. When you have no money, why don't you think of giving? Everybody say giving.
Yeah.
So some people don't want to hear giving, but look at what Jesus said in Luke chapter 6 verse 38. He says, give, and it shall be given back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shake it together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom. Say, for the same measure that you measured out, the same shall be measured back to you. Clap your hands and celebrate giving. You can give yourself out of poverty. There is a law. When you give, God, Jesus says, people will give back to you. Hallelujah. Sometimes, pastor used to say this, but you know that one of the most used human resources is the pastor. I've been a pastor for over 30 years. Sometimes I feel people use me. And I know when people use me. There are people that they can call you and say, pastor, come. I have this. And they want you to jump into your car, jump into anything and rush to the place. But you can't call them and say, can you do this for us? They will say, no, pastor, I don't have time. Everybody expects pastor to give them their time, but you don't give pastor, not even God, your time. Giving is not only about money. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, I'm not saying that so that you can be giving me, but I'll be happy if you give me your time and give God your time. Clap your hands and celebrate Jesus. Number five, hidden truth. This one is controversial. And you know that I've not even come to this pulpit since we started this church in 4 years and said, today, I'm preaching on tithe and offering. I'm not a desperate pastor when it comes to tithe and offering. I don't preach desperate messages when it comes to tithe and offering. I don't even preach extreme judgmental messages when it comes to tithe. Have you ever heard me say that before? Because, you see, God will always provide for the church. We may have lack, we may have need. If you choose not to pay your tithe, God will always provide for the church. I believe in tithe. Jesus teaches about tithe. Praise the name of the Lord. But do you know that the support God has given to you for your vision is your tithe? And God said, he said, if you pay your tithe, he said, I will open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that there be no limit. Now, a lot of people are looking for the windows of heaven. But he said also, he said, and I will rebuke devourers for your sake. Tithe creates a supernatural protection over your income. Look at what Jesus said in Matthew 23, verse 23. So that you know tithing is approved in the New Testament. Praise the name of the Lord. Matthew 23, verse 23. Matthew 23, verse 23. Don't worry, just flow with me. Matthew 23, verse 23. Are you there? Let's read together. One, two, go. Let's read, go. Are you there? If you're there, shout amen.
Amen.
If you're there, shout amen.
Amen.
If you are looking for it, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, let's read. One, two, go. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye pay tithes of mint and anise, and pay tithes of cumin, and omitted the weightier matter of the law, and judgment, mercy, and faith. This ought ye to have done, and not to leave the other undone. So Jesus did not say you shouldn't pay your tithe if you have the grace. What is tithe? Tithe is just 10% of your business income. Your gifts. Some people pay tithe, but they don't pay tithe of all. Even gifts in your life, you can pay tithe of it. You try God, and it's a covenant. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's look at the fifth one. The sixth one is called sacrifices. The hidden provision for your vision that will bring money into your life is called sacrifices. Before Solomon stumbled on the blessings from God, he offered 1,000 sacrifices. In 1 Samuel chapter 24, verse 24, 2 Samuel 24, 24, David said, no to Arauna. He said, I will not offer unto my God that which does not cost me anything. Everybody say sacrifices. Do you know that sacrifice is the support for your vision? What are you willing to sacrifice? Praise the name of the Lord. Do you know, Brother Grace, maybe he has an appointment, but do you know that there are people that they are putting on the latest shoes, designer shoes. They put on latest jeans, designer jeans, latest shirt. Some of the guys is talking about that they don't have money for their vision. Nothing latest passes them by. Latest phone. Somebody is using $1,000 phone. There are people that are using iPhone X in Nigeria that Brotepe is talking about. And they keep complaining they don't have money to start their vision. Some people, you just need to sit down and calculate how much you spend on a bottle of beer. Some of them, tell them to sit down and calculate how much a pack of cigarettes is. Even in this city. Some of those cigarettes are as expensive as $30, $50. And some people smoke 4 packs in a day. And keeps complaining because the government will give them welfare. They don't have money for their vision. Multiply 30 by 5 every day. One way or the other, that's why they always rob dairy stores. May you not smoke away your vision.
Amen.
May your vision not be tied down in new shoes that you don't need to impress people that you don't like. Kingdom interest is another disguised provision. I've taught you before, when Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, it means that when you seek the interest of the kingdom of God, God will seek your interest. Kingdom interest is another support for your vision that you may get. Obedience to ridiculous divine leadings. It's another support that God has made available for the vision that you have. For instance, if Jesus told you to go to the sea and take up a fish, that the money you need is there, will you believe? Some of us are still looking for jobs. When God is saying, start a business, build a business, start a business, you pray and fast and pray and fast and pray and fast and pray and fast. You can work for any man in this world, but nobody can become rich working for another man. Do you know that? So Jesus, sometimes the ridiculous instruction will come to a woman. He said, go and borrow all the vessels in the city. If she had disobeyed the servant of God, would she have become rich? Obedience sometimes to ridiculous divine instruction. When the Holy Spirit spoke to you and said, give that thing to that person that has need. Support that thing they were doing in the church. You never knew that it was a way of God, you know, wanting to bless you. You thought it was a way of God you want to take away from you. No, no. No, no. Number 9, hidden provision for your vision is wisdom and understanding now. When God will answer Solomon, he said, I have blessed you with wisdom and understanding heart. Wisdom is different from understanding heart. Praise the name of the Lord. He said, I have blessed you with wisdom and understanding heart. Number 10 is riches. 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 Number 11 is honor. I want to emphasize a little bit before we pray on this. On everybody say honor. Honor, honor, honor. You see, one man said, most of us are looking for money. Most of us are looking for money. When I read this scripture during the week, I began to pray. I discovered that the reason why we are laboring, we want money, we want this, is because of honor. He said, you are laboring, you are asking for money. He said, when you get the money, what will you use your money to buy? You think people that buy Jaguars, Bentley, expensive, you know what they are looking for? They want everybody to honor them. Praise the name of the Lord. Pray for honor in your life. Then lastly, supplies of all your needs is under eating provision. Look at Proverbs chapter 4, verse 19, and I close. I close with a story. Leave this thing, leave this thing. Just focus on the teaching and pray. We are about to close. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to share a story and then we'll pray. Praise the name of the Lord. Proverbs chapter, Philippians chapter 4, verse 19 says, but my God shall supply all your needs. Do you see there that God says he will give you all the money you need? He says, but my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. If you want to start a cleaning business, for instance, and you are praying, God, the budget I need to start this cleaning business is $30,000. I want to buy a franchise. I want to do this, I want to do that. And you keep praying and you keep praying. And then you needed some asset that will cost you like $10,000. And somebody give you one asset alone that will cost you $5,000. Do you really need $5,000 for that asset's worth? So when God says, my God shall supply all your needs, the most important thing is that the need that will make the vision to come to pass, God supplies it. There was a woman in Nigeria who built a billions of naira massive investment called Swiss Sensation. That woman was a banker. I like to read people like that. She was a banker and she had no time to take care of her children because she lives in Lagos. She wakes up at half 4 a.m. and comes back around 10 p.m. And then she decided to resign. And then she wanted to build Swiss Sensation, if you remember the store. It's still in Nigeria. And then she said in the article, she said, I went to my dad's house and I saw old ACs that my dad has abandoned in the store. Tables and chairs. He packed all of them, rented a place. That is how Swiss Sensation started. Clap your hands and celebrate Jesus. He has no money, but God supplied the needs to produce the vision. Praise the name of the Lord. So the missing link is this. Everybody say missing link. Provision. Because there is a provision for every vision that you have and our God has given to you. There were two American young boys. Popular stories, true life stories. I don't know which one to tell you. There were two stories of two guys. One was Italian. Let me tell you the Italian one. Or do you want the American one? Which one do you want? Okay, I think the Italian would make more sense. There were two Italian young guys. One is Pablo, one is Bruno. True life. And in their city, in those days, they were the only guys that had strength to carry buckets of water to supply the city. So, both of them were making good money, fetching water from the stream that is far away from the village and supplying people in the city. It got to a time, I wouldn't know which one of them because I don't want to mix it. But for the sake of this story, I'll call the one that was having a vision, Pablo. Pablo began to think that if we continue this way, it's going to come to a time we are going to grow old and we will not be able to fetch water from that long distance again. So he began to think of what nobody has ever thought before in the history of the world. Build a pipeline from the stream and bring it to the village. Everybody laughing to scorn. Say, you are a useless man. Do you think it's possible? Have you seen somebody do it before? Now you have faucets. Now you have pipelines that have been laid from streams and have been channeled to homes. But that was the first guy that did it. So when he started it, it took him a lot of time. He was failing. The thing was cracking. The thing was breaking. It was not working. Everybody was laughing at him. But you know what happened? When he started building his vision of a pipeline, his bucket-carrying friend keep on carrying bucket.
So he carried more bucket than Pablo. So he had more money than Pablo. In fact, during that period, that particular period, Bruno bought a white horse, which is like Lamborghini in those days, and parked it in front of his house to show everybody that he has arrived. Because now he's not only carrying the bucket that is a location that can bring money to him, he's also carrying the bucket of Pablo, who is busy building pipeline and could not carry enough bucket to supply suppliers. Come on, say, may God not make me a bucket carrier. You are either a bucket carrier or a pipeline builder. So eventually, in fact, I read in the story that Bruno, when he gets to the tavern, they call it tavern, when he gets to the tavern, he will put money on the table, he will say, serve everyone. Because he's got enough money. He's got more than enough money. So they will serve everybody, they will drink. But eventually, it was so exciting. Pablo's pipeline worked. Pablo got faucet. And then the water started flowing to the city. So you will go, do you need water in your house? You pay me so, and I will channel the... And then everybody was paying Pablo. And then people were no more patronizing Bruno. At the same time, Bruno grew old, and his back became bent. He couldn't carry bucket again. Eventually, he went to his friend, say, employ me. Now Pablo can sit at home, and water flows without carrying a bucket. Those who build pipelines will eventually employ bucket builders. It's a matter of time. I'll tell you the second story next week. As we look at where money is hiding. See, I'm not there. Don't think I'm rich. But I'm comfortable. But I believe in sharing a vision. Even when I have not stepped into the fullness of it, we will get there. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Rise up on your feet and say, I decree and declare. I'm walking in abundance. Moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus. I pray whatever that is not making me to be favored. I am favored. Make sure you pray that prayer. I'm walking in abundance. I'm walking in abundance. I'm walking in abundance. Pray. In Jesus' name we pray. I want you to pray on this. Hold somebody's hand and say, in the name of Jesus. May you walk in abundance. No, don't do 2x2. Say, may you walk in abundance. 2x2. Put 2x2, not 4x4. Just hold one so person now so that I can be more focused. Say, Brooke and I may say, may you walk in abundance. Move with the speed of the Holy Ghost. May you be favored in the name of Jesus. In the name, open your mouth and pray. May you walk in abundance. May you move with the speed of the Holy Ghost. May you be favored in the name of Jesus. May you walk in abundance. May you move with the speed of the Holy Ghost. May you be favored in the name of Jesus. May you walk in abundance. May you move with the speed of the Holy Ghost. May you be favored in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Finally, you will say it 7 times. The Bible says how forcible a right was. And I've tried this several times. When I lack money, I'll just say, money, come here. To me, now, I read all kinds. I listen to all kinds of revelations. I read that month's book maybe about 7-8 years ago. Larry Thompson, Money Comment Now. I'm telling you, it's a revelation. And I believe you can speak to money to come because the Bible says, how forcible a right word. Come on, say money.
Money.
Needed for my vision. Come in now. Repeat this one time. Say money.
Money.
Come in to me now.
To me
in the name
now.
Of Jesus. Money.
Money.
For my vision.
Come
in to me now.
Money.
For my vision.
Come
in to me now. Give one to your family. Say money.
Money.
For the vision of our family.
Come
in to us now. Money. For the vision of this church. Come in to us now. In the name of Jesus. Money coming to us now.
Money
coming to us now.
Money
coming to us now. In Jesus' name we pray. Finally, stretch forth your hands at me and say, whatever the Holy Spirit puts in your mind.
Jesus, my all. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for your word that has come to us today. Thank you for the revelation. Thank you for the encouragement. Thank you for the enlightenment to our spirits about the importance of our vision. Maybe in the past we've been discouraged and wondering how the provision will come. Thank you for the revelation you've given unto us today. We ask that the grace to trust you and to see and to begin to follow the step itemized for us today. Lord, you grant unto us the grace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, we ask that for each and every one of us, O God, our life will become enriched the more by today's revelation in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you for the verse you have used. We ask that his life also will become enriched the more by the revelation he has shared in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We bless you, Lord, because we believe you have answered. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Let's share the grace in fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, the blessedness shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall give the dance of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Thank you for watching. We hope you were blessed. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video with your friends.